Hi, my name is Nicolas Biais. I'm an assistant professor of biology here at Brooklyn College, part of CUNY. And I've been tasked to try to explain to you a little bit what are the experiments that won the Nobel Prize of Chemistry 2017. It's based on a new technique that is absolutely astonishing called Cryo EM. So cryo for very cold and EM for electron microscopy. So what is it all about? It's about getting to see the very shape of the molecules that are making life feasible. And so for the longest time, the only way we had was a little crude. We basically had only like rough sketches of what those shapes could be. Three people, so a Swiss person, a German that became American, and a British person, combined over decades to find ways for us to get beautiful, beautiful, very extremely precise images of the shape of life molecules. How did they do this? So Jacques Dubochet, the Swiss person, found a way to freeze time. You can actually take molecules that you're interested in and just have them exactly keep the shape they would have and the interaction they would have working inside one of your cells or maybe bacterial cells, and just be exactly what they were doing. So no change. Then Joachim Frank, which is now at Columbia University, and I had a chance to actually interact a little bit with when I took his classes on cryo-EM a few years back, when I was myself at Columbia University for a postdoc. He used actually informatics and like computer to be able to average out all those images that you can take now that you can actually freeze time and freeze those molecules exactly in the specific shape that they have. And the last person, Richard Anderson, the British citizen, what he was able to do is to find ways to get not only like a image, but a super extremely precise image all the way down to atomic resolution of all those specific molecules that you can have. Really like the insight that were gained by that technique, cryo-EM technique, has been really, really, really important. Of course, it's not the end all of every single thing. You still have to have genetics, to have like a good understanding of like everything else about that system, but really having that map, almost like a, I don't know, basically comparing what we had before. If you wanted to find your way a long time ago to go someplace, you had like a little sketch, or you actually had to ask people who knew where to go. Basically, thanks to cryo-EM, is basically having access directly to Google Earth to be able to download and have a perfect map of where to go and how to actually orient yourself. So it is not that different, but it makes everything much, much, much easier. And so that's why we hope that by using cryo-EM ourselves, we'll be able to understand even better our system.